Hello everyone, welcome to MifraTech. Today in this section we will see one basic important machine learning library, that is sklearn, scikit-learn. So these are the concepts we are going to cover in this video. First we will see what is scikit-learn or sklearn, and what are the features of sklearn library, and what are the different operations can be performed using this scikit-learn library, and what are the benefits of sklearn, and what are the different applications of sklearn. So let's start our discussion with what is sklearn. So sklearn is the most useful and robust machine learning library for Python coding. So it mainly provides efficient tools for machine handling and both machine learning projects, and both for statistical modeling and plotting library, etc. So it also includes like classification, regression, clustering, dimensionality reduction, so all kind of machine learning problems related algorithms and pre-processing techniques, all like data handling techniques, all those will be available in this sklearn library. So it is a large library which is written in Python. It is mainly built upon depending libraries like NumPy, SciPy and Matplotlib. So let's see what are the different features of this sklearn library. So as I told, it mainly provides some inbuilt data sets, and it also helps to import some of the data sets stored in our devices, and also helps in extracting features like what are the different features which are affecting our final output from a data set can be drawn using this feature selection and feature extraction. You can also do some parameter tuning, and there is a clustering and class validation. You can get a supervised models, unsupervised models, and dimensionality reduction, example like PCA. And you can find out ensemble methods like random forest decision tree. So all kind of machine learning problems related algorithms, techniques you can find using this sklearn library. So these are the different features you can find in this library. So let's see what are the different operations can be performed using this sklearn library. So first we'll see how to import a data set. So by using this sklearn library, we can import a data set that is already we can get in predefined in sklearn library, or which can be stored in our device. So first we'll see how to import a data set. Before that, first we have to install sklearn using pip install sklearn in our command prompt. So after that, to import our data set, first we have to import sklearn library, we have to use the command import sklearn. After the library has been imported, here to handle the data we are using one node dependent library, that is pandas. So for that we have to use the command import pandas as pd. After that, to load any data set, we can use the from sklearn dot data set. Here we are using a predefined data set already available in sklearn, that is iris data set. So that is a commonly used machine learning data set. So to load this iris data set, we have to use the command from sklearn dot data sets, we have to import load underscore iris. So after importing this iris data set, we are assigning this loaded iris data set to one variable, that is iris. So after that, we are converting this iris data set into data frame by using pandas library. For that, the command is pd.dataframe of, so that we are giving iris data as the input. Then columns name we are giving as iris feature underscore name. So iris dataset feature column, like heading features, we are taken as a column. So if I print, we are going to get a data frame. So also the next operation we'll see data exploration, which is nothing but how we can handle or how we can visualize our data which is available in the data set using this sklearn. For that, we can get a different commands like head of function, tail of function. So first we'll see what is this head of. This head of function, what it will do means, if you use this head of function, it is going to display the in our top 5 rows of our data set values. So let's use this. So for that command is, the already we have created a data frame from the iris, which will be stored in df underscore iris in our previous importing data set. So this is already wrote data set, we are printing only head, that is df underscore iris dot head of is going to give output the first 5 data, like 5 rows of data from our data set. So as we can see, our data set mainly consists of these columns, that is sepal length, sepal width, petal length and petal width. So this head is going to give us to by default it is will give the top 5 rows as in the inside this head parameter. If we can mention how many number of data we want, if we mention as 10, it is going to give top 10 rows of data from our data set. Like this we can visualize our data using this head function. And there is one more called tail. What this tail is, it is like opposite to head, so it is going to give a bottom 5 rows of data from our data set by default. If we can mention how many data numbers if we want, if we mention 20, bottom 20 of rows of data set from our given data set will be available by using this tail. To implement, we have using the command df underscore from iris dataset dot tail. So last like bottom 5 rows of data from our given data set will be available by using this command. So next we'll see how to visualize our data. So visualizing a data set is very important to handle or solve any machine learning problems. So let's see, for which data visualization, here we are make use of the plotting library, that is matplotlib. We have already imported sklearn and pandas library. So in this command we are importing matplot, that is import matplotlib.pyplot as plt. After importing the matplotlib, so from pandas.plotting import, we are importing a scatter matrix. So to visualize our data, features of our data set in a plotting library in a graph, we are using this scatter matrix. After that scatter matrix, so scatter underscore matrix of in for iris data set, we are giving as a data for this scatter matrix. For that we can mention the figure size as a parameter. So figure size means in your graph how much length and width of graph you want, that we can mention. Here we given as a 10x10. So after that, to see our output, we are using plt.show. If you run this or execute this code, we are going to get output like this. So we are going to get a mat, like a plotting graph. The graph which contains all the iris data features will be plotted in a graph. So which contains all the, you can see petal width, petal width, sepal length, sepal width as a features. So this is how you can visualize our data using a matplotlib library using sklearn. So one more, we can also visualize our data using this seaborn library. It is also a plotting library. So let's see how to do that. First we have to import seaborn as SNS. After that we can set the colors of code what we want in our graph. After setting that, we will load the data set using sns.load underscore data, the iris data set which I have already stored, we are loading. After that, to plot this, we are using sns.pairplot. This is the a style we are plotting our data set. So let's see what is the output we'll get after executing these commands. So this is our final graph, what we are getting in the using the seaborn library. So it will be very helpful in visualizing our data. As you can see, that red blue color indicates the Setosa species of iris, and orange color indicates Vasi color, and green color indicates Virginica. So these are the three different iris species of flower we can see on our data set. So that will be we can easily visualize our data set using this seaborn library along with sklearn. So the fourth one we'll see, data pre-processing. So data pre-processing an important step, because we cannot provide a raw data to any machine learning algorithms or machine learning process, because it will reduce our final efficiency or accuracy of the model. To reduce, to increase the accuracy of our model, we should handle the data. So we should do pre-processing of the data. So there are certain more number of features available in pre-processing. So this pre-processing will be available in sklearn library. So let's see how to do that. First we'll see label encoding. That is one of the important pre-processing technique. Label encoding is nothing but it will convert any non-numeric data available in the data set to numerical data type, because our machine learning algorithm will handle only numerical values. So to do that, first we have to taking our iris data set. Our main data set only contains 4 features, that is sepal length, sepal width, petal length and petal width. We are adding one more column for that is species, that is Virginica, Versicolor and Virginica. There are 3 iris data species. So those will be added as a species. So that I have added to an array and taken it as a label. After that, I am importing a pre-processing label encoder using from sklearn.preprocessing. In this pre-processing module, I am importing label encoder, as I told what label encoder will do. So after importing label encoder, I am assigning it a variable le. After that, we'll implement this label encoding to our from our data set for that species column, which is a string column. For that, we'll convert into a numerical value. If I apply this le.fit and of labels, so after after performing the list label encoding for that particular column, we are going to get output like 0, 1, 2, because it will map all the string values to some numerical value. So this is how we'll do label encoding with the help of sklearn library. So in the similar way, we can also do some of the using some dictionaries also. So also we can drop unwanted columns in our data set using this drop function. That is, from iris data set, I am dropping like sepal, length, sepal width and species, these column. So I have to mention axis is equal to, whether we are dropping a column means we have to get axis is equal to 1. If it is a row means we have to mention axis is equal to 0 as a parameter. So by using this drop function, we can drop unwanted columns or rows in our data set. Also, we can select our features and make it as a dictionary. Then by using this from sklearn.feature extract, so we can extract important features from our data set using this sklearn.feature extraction. So after that, you are importing a dict vectorizer, which is a dictionary oriented. So from that, to implement this, we have to fit underscore transform. We are giving the features to an array. So if I if we print this code, we are going to get a output like what are the different feature that is affecting our final output using this feature extraction. So we can, after these pre-processing training all over, the important machine learning step is have to data splitting. That is, we have to take from entire data set, we have to split our data set for training and testing. So that will also be done by using this sklearn library only. So let's see how to do that. From sklearn.model_selection, in this model_selection module, we have to import train test place. This train_test_split. So this train test split is going to split our entire data set for training and testing purpose based on the parameters we mentioned as an input. So after that, importing train test split, we have to give input for the train test split. So for train test split, there is parameters like we are giving input as a features as a x, and one more data target as a label, that is nothing but the last species. And for test size, we have to mention how much of data set we want for testing purpose. So test_size, if we mention it as 0.20, means out of 100, whole data set, 20% of will be taken for testing purpose and remaining 80 will be taken for training purpose. So this random_state, this parameter or attribute will mention if we mention it as 10, means the entire whole data set will be shuffled 10 times. So if we default, it will be 0. So after giving all this input, we are collecting our output. So our splitted output will look like, from feature, we'll get a training data set, feature_train. Same from features, we'll get for testing purpose, same label_train, label_test. So we'll getting output as a 4 column, 4 variables we can store those values. So after splitting our entire data set, we have to choose the model, means nothing but we have to choose an appropriate algorithm for our data set to get or predict our output. So in sklearn, we can get this algorithm cheat sheet. So this will help us to see which type of problem our data set will belongs to and what type of algorithm we have to use in order to solve our problem. So as you can see, there is a classification algorithms available like SVC, Ensemble, Navibase, KNN, Kernel. So these are the classification algorithms you can find out in sklearn, and there is a clustering algorithms like K-means clustering, so the GMM. So, and also you can see a regression algorithms like linear regression, SVR, Ensemble regressor. So these are the different regression algorithms you can find in sklearn library. and there is one more called like dimensionality reduction. So to reduce our entire data set into like to reduce the dimensionality of our data set, we can also find some of the algorithms like PCA, principal component analysis, and kernel approximation. So these are the different four category of algorithms we can find in this sklearn library. So by using all these algorithms, we can build a model and we can use that to predict our output. So let's see what are the like which algorithms we can use for our high risk data set. So in to build a model, we have to choose a classifier. As I told, this high risk data set, we are mainly doing classification of different iris species, mainly as three, that is Versicolor, Virginica and Setosa. So do that, as is a, it is a classification problem, we are using classifying algorithm. So in this example, I am using SVM, that is support vector machine algorithm, to classify my iris data species. So let's see how to build a model. From sklearn dot, I am importing SVM import SVC. I am importing from SVM. As I told, SVM support vector machine will get two types of like support vector classifier and support vector regression. But in this example, we have to use a classifier. So only from SVM, I am importing SVC, that is support vector classifier. After the algorithm has been imported, we have to set some of the parameters in that algorithm. So in this, I am setting a kernel is equal to linear. So I am using classifier as a linear, as my problem is a linear problem, I am using kernel is equal to linear. And after setting the parameter, to train the model, we have to give the input parameter, that is a training data set. So to do that, we have to use dot fit of. I am giving features training and labels training as a data set for training our model. After the model has been trained, we have to predict our output. So to predict the output, we are using the dot predict function, that is SVM underscore model linear underscore, after the model we gave is stored in this variable. So dot predict of, we have to give the training data set which have to predict. So feature underscore train, after we predict the output, our output will be stored in SVM underscore prediction. So this is a user defined variable, you can give it as like what you want. And after the predicted output stored in this, have to check the accuracy of the training and accuracy of testing. So let's do that. To do that, we have to use from SVM underscore model. There is a matrix matrix model available in SVM to check accuracy error from any machine learning model. To do that, we have to use the dot score function. For that, what it will mainly do is it will compare the predicted value and the actual value, and it will give the difference between them to find out the accuracy. So we are giving for the score function feature underscore train and label underscore train. So these are the two we are gave for training purpose, as you can see. So it will compare from these and it will check what is the training accuracy. So as you can see, to find accuracy stored in this accuracy variable, if we print this accuracy, so our training accuracy in this case will be 95.83% accuracy we can get using this SVM machine. So let's see what is the test accuracy for this algorithm. So as you can see, in the similar way, have to like import everything after predicting, but in this case we are predicting features underscore test data. For calculation of accuracy, we have to give for score function we are checking the testing accuracy. So feature underscore test and label underscore test, so these are the actual and predicted value we are giving. So after it compare the output, it mainly give us testing accuracy as 1.0, so is nothing but 100% accuracy it is giving, because iris is basic data set, it contains only less number of 150 of rows of columns, so it is giving highest accuracy for using SVC. So let's implement using another algorithm. In the similar way, we can use another algorithm or a different model we can build using this one more labor algorithm, k nearest neighbor, KNN. Is a k nearest neighbors classifier is almost one of the important classification algorithm. So let's see how to implement that. First, we have to import from sklearn.neighbors. In the dot neighbors module, we have to import a k nearest classifier. So it will be available in neighbors module. After importing this kneighbor library algorithm, we have to set some of the parameters, like what are the for calculation, mainly in k nearest neighbors, we have to set the number of neighbors we are taken for our calculation. For that, we have to give n underscore neighbors as 7. For here, I have taken in this example 7 means it is going to consider 7 nearest neighbors to calculate our final predict our output. After that, to train the model, we have to give input, that is, to we have to fit the model. That fit we are giving training, that is feature underscore train and labels underscore train. After train the model, we will check accuracy of our training by using the KNN dot score feature underscore. So training data, we have to give us the input to check the training accuracy. In this example, we are getting exact 95.8 training accuracy. So let's check what is the testing accuracy. As you can see, similar way, we have to predict the output and train the model and predict the output. After that, to check the accuracy, in this case, we are checking testing accuracy. So we have to give feature underscore test and label underscore test as a parameter. After it has been given, let's print our accuracy. So we are getting a 1.0 as the accuracy. As I told, it is the basic data set, so only we are getting more accuracy. When you use a real world problems which contains a 1,000, 2,000 millions of rows of data set, for those data set you can get a lesser accuracy. But it depends on data set and what kind of problem, which appropriate algorithm using. Depending on that, we will get our final accuracy. So these are the different stages of machine learning algorithms or any machine learning project will work. To do that, we have to use this sklearn library, which is an important, which will provide data pre-processing, model building, and evaluating our model, and different plotting techniques, data handling techniques. All those will be available in this sklearn library. As I told, it's the basic machine learning library you have to know before doing any machine learning projects or any executing any code. So let's see what are the benefits of this sklearn library. As I told, it is a open source. You need not to pay for anything. So it is open for everyone. You can use it very easily, and it is very easy to use. As I told, and you can easily learn this sklearn library. And document detailing. So it mainly offers document detailing of the API that users can access at any time. So in sklearn official website library, you can find all the details you want about this sklearn library. And there is extensive use in niche. It is mainly extensively used in all different organization for predicting consumer behavior, identify suspicious activities and much more. So in different real-time problems it is using. And sklearn, it mainly provides lot of machine learning related algorithms related to clustering, as I told, regression, classification, dimensionality reduction, different kinds of algorithm it will provide us. And it as I told, algorithm flowchart will be available like this. So what are the different applications of sklearn? So sklearn is a library that contains several implementations of machine learning algorithm. As I told, you can find an n number of implementation, and it is used in cyber security analytics, for product development, in neuroimaging, barcode scanner development. In medical modeling also we can use this library. So it mainly provides us regression modeling, unsupervised classification and clustering problems, a decision tree pruning, you can find it in ensemble learning module. And it is also mainly for training and testing our model we can use. And it will provide us different decision boundary algorithms SVMs, advanced probability modeling also. We can find out the probability of our model to calculate the accuracy using advanced probability modeling. We can do a feature extraction and feature selection. There's a dimensionality reduction feature we can see, and we can see outlier detection reduction. So these are the different kinds of features you can find it in our, you can call it as applications where you can use this sklearn library. So as I told, it mainly for feature processing, feature selection, hyperparameter tuning, for model selection. For all these purposes, you can use this sklearn library. And who uses this? So these are the different platform or where the people are using sklearn for finding all these apps or platforms website you can see. So these are the different applications of sklearn library. Thank you, everyone.